Well, the question of the week is, have you had a good time in Vacation Bible School? Yeah, we're glad that you are here tonight for our family night. I hope you've just had a great week. We have. We're going to do just a couple of songs that the kids learned in Bible school. And I'm going to do a little bit of mission presentation and show you how much they learned about our mission partners that are already in place for New Providence. So we'll do that. And then going to do some pledges and quote our memory verse and a theme and motto for the week. Then we're going to have a baptism. But all that we're hoping is going to take us about 20 minutes or so, not too long, so we can get outside, we hope. It looks like there's a dark cloud, but all week, every single night, God has given us good weather and favor, so we're hoping He'll do that one more night for Bible School Week. But we're having a great time, and we just appreciate you so much for being here with us. Thank you, guys. You guys are awesome. And parents and grandparents, thanks for letting us borrow your kids this week. They were all excellent. Didn't have any problems except out of my two granddaughters, but everybody else was really good. But those two are always my problems. But anyway, we had a great week, and teachers, you all were awesome. I have no idea how many teachers that it takes to pull this thing off, but with teachers and security in the parking lots and adults working, running recreation and crafts and all of those things, and then counters for the food and counters for the money and all of that. So it just takes an army to do this, but you did it, and I am so thankful and so proud of you for that. You guys are awesome, and we appreciate you very, 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 very much. So thank you for all of that. If you're joining us online, welcome. We're only going to be inside for a few minutes, so it'll be less than 30 minutes. So we say greetings to you. Thanks for showing up and celebrating with us tonight for our final celebration of Vacation Bible School. Then we are going to go outside and play on these giant bounce houses. There's homemade ice cream being cranked out there right now and watermelon on ice. And so all of that's going to happen for those of us who are here. Those of you who are out there in the internet land, sorry, you can just enjoy part of the fun, okay? Then you can go get an ice cream cone or something from your freezer. But we're glad everybody's here. It's going to be a great night, and we thank you so very much. Let me pray with you to get us started. Heavenly Father, you are good and great. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go and do Vacation Bible School. It was great after last year, 2020, not being able to have Bible school. It's been great to do it this year, and we praise you and thank you, Lord, for what you've done. Now, Lord, just go with us. Keep us in your hands and care. We're going to give you praise for all that you do. In the mighty and awesome name of Jesus, amen and amen. Every night when we came into Bible school, the kids would all come in. We bring them in immediately and seat them in their groups with their age group. And we do that, and they're all sitting there. We have some challenges and all that. But the first thing we do is to go over our pledges and our memory verse. So I'm not sure if all my flag bearers are here. Some are and some are not. So I know that Natalie's here. Come on down, Nat. And one of the Pinkstons. You're a Mathis. There you go. And so I think Miles is running the camera tonight. He was one of our flag bearers. And then Cricket, is she here? I don't see her. So, okay, Rebecca, come on down. You got to help me, kid. I can always count on my Pinkettes. They can do it. So there you go. Yay, girl. All right, come on down. And every night, we meet down here and we do the pledges, and we do a pledge to the United States flag. It's really the only time of the year that we do that in the church services, and unless you go to a ball game anymore, we just don't do it, but we love America. We are thankful for this great nation. We're thankful for all of the first responders, police, fire, all of those folks who allow us the protection, our U.S. military, our governmental system, as crazy and messed up as it is right now. We are thankful that God has given us this country, and for more than 200 years, we've stood for freedom and liberty and justice for all. So we're thankful for that, and so we want to train up our children to pledge their allegiance to the flag, and we try to honor that. Then we also do for the Christian flag, obviously, as believers, and then the pledge to the Bible, okay? So I need you parents to do it, but kids, you all are the stars for the week, okay? So I need you to show them how we do this stuff. Are you good? All right, so everybody stand up with us. Let's do that. We're going to first do the pledge to the United States flag. And we ask every night, and this is a good look, I knew they kept kind of sneaking in. But all of you who are here tonight, we thank you, and again, we welcome you. We ask you to do the pledge to the United States flag, and we ask everyone to stand up in respect, stand straight and tall, take off your hats if you're wearing one, put your hand on your heart. We're giving pledge to this great country. Are you ready? Attention, salute the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. How about a round of applause for the grand old flag? She's a high-flying flag. Then we do the pledge to the Christian flag. Are you ready? Again, take off your hats. Attention. Salute the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag, to the Christian flag, and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One brotherhood uniting all Christians in service and love. Thank you. How about a round of applause for the Christian flag and a round of applause for me for getting the pledge? There you go. Thank you for that. And then finally, the Bible. We can't have Bible school without the Bible. So we're so thankful and honored to do that. So we're going to do the pledge to the Bible. Would you join me? Attention. Salute the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word, and will make it a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path, and hide its words in my heart, that I might not sin against God. There you go. Thank you. A round of applause for the Bible and all of our flag bearers all week, and Rebecca standing the gap tonight. Thank you, guys. We appreciate you so much. Then every night after we would do the pledges, we would do our challenge, canned food challenge, and we would do that by age grade. The first sections over here were our pre-K and then kindergarten. Once they would come and bring their offering, we have a scale in there with some big, great big pink bucket and a large blue bucket, and we would have those on the scale, and the kids would bring them in, and I would be shouting the whole time, asking a question. Plug your ears, old people. Who do you think's going to win? I can't hear you. Who's going to win? Come on, you got to be kidding me. Who's going to win? The boys or the girls? It would go something like that, but we're missing about 100 kids. So just imagine what it was like as they were screaming their heads off. And then I would call them down by age group first, the pre-K. They would come down, and then they had a rope with some little loops in it. I thought they were nooses the first night, but it was a handle. And so the 8 or 10 kids would come in, and a leader would take them, and they would grab the rope, and they'd go on to their class. Then kindergarten would come down, and they would do the same thing, give theirs. And each time between them, I would yell and scream and ask who was going to win. So they would all come. The kindergartners would then march out. Then we began with the first grade all the way through eighth grade. Oh, and our adults met, but they never came in here because they're too old to shout and give any money. So we didn't let them come in and join us. They had a class going on already. Each grade would come, and they would come and bring theirs in, and then just circle back around and be seated, because we did a missions moment every night after that was done, okay? So every night they came and brought offerings, and I just wanted to give you some totals for the week with the canned food challenge. The totals were, the girls brought in 1,289 cans, and the boys brought in 1,260. There was a grand total of 2,548 cans that we're going to deliver next week to the Good Samaritan here in Loudoun County. All right? That's awesome, yeah. 2,549. That's marvelous. And we talked about the Good Samaritan. We'll do that in just a moment as well. Also, the offering challenge for money, the giving of money, we're going to share that with our mission partners. We discussed each night one of the mission partners that we already have at New Providence Baptist Church. We typically get a mission partner for 5 years at a time. We enter a partnership agreement, and the agreement is something like this. For the next 5 years, If you're doing a kingdom work and you need help, we got your back. And we will go there and help do Bible schools and pastors' conferences and preaching services, evangelism, construction projects, anything they, if they're doing something for the Lord in any of those locations, and I'll describe those to you in a moment, we'll go there and help them. So these funds are used to help pay for some of those activities or whatever that mission partner needs. But for the week, the girls won the challenge, by the way, for canned food. For the week, the girls brought in a total of $1,387, which is pretty awesome as well. The boys brought in a total of $1,404. So the boys won the offering challenge. And I'll just be honest with you, my granddaughters have been with me all week. Two of them were. And so every night I was giving them money and taking food, canned food, out of my cabinets. Anybody else have this? Last night I went up to visit with Carol's family at the Receiving Friends. And when I got back home, I hadn't eaten, so I thought, I'm going to eat something. So I opened up my cabinet. There was nothing in there. There was a can of beef broth, maybe some asparagus or something, and a can of carrots. Everything else was gone. It's here, so I hope Loudoun County enjoys it. But I think some of you also emptied cabinets, and it was great fun and all that. Well, the girls, I was doing that every night, giving them four or five cans and some cash. I have one grandson. I have five grandchildren, one grandson. Doodah over there. Judah Isaac is my namesake. He carries my ears with him into the future. He's my boy, the last Caldwell. And I think that both of my sons are too old to have any more, although I'm praying that they will. But anyway, Judah is, so I said to him, and the boys were behind in canned food. So I said, Judah, I said, I'm going to go do something. So I went grocery shopping and bought 200 cans of food so the boys could win. That was my plan. I bring it in on a two-wheeler. The first graders come in. His dad brings this two-wheeler down, and the food's stacked up. We're cheering. We know we got it. And the girls beat us. I couldn't believe it. I bought 200 cans. Yes, you little brats. So anyway, but the girls for the week brought in $1,387.04 in offerings. The boys brought in $1,404.05. So the boys did win in the total offering. For the week, for our missionaries, we're going to divide up $2,791.09. That is awesome. Really cool. They did a great job, and we appreciate them. We enrolled 226, pretty good number, especially after a pandemic and all those things and this late in the year. So anyway, it's a great week, and we just appreciated all those things that they did. Then that was the opening assembly. Then after we did that, the kids would sit back down, and I would tell them about a couple mission projects. First one was the first night talking about the Good Samaritan, where the canned food was going. And so kids, I need you to raise your hand to answer some questions. Where is the Good Samaritan ministry? Yes, ma'am. Lenore City and Loudoun. There are two offices here in our county. So if you have a problem, you can go there and get food. So who can get food from the Good Samaritan? Yes, sir. Anybody who needs food can go there and they'll get it. All of the churches in the county work together bringing food to that one central place, so they have a much larger supply than individual churches trying to have a food closet. A lot of times in rural areas they'll do that, but a lot of times then the food will go, before they need it, it'll go bad or something. Here they use a lot of food, and all the about 100 churches are involved to bring it in there. So it's in Loudoun and Lenore City, or as two of the kid said, Leonard City. I don't know who that, but we're in, apparently in the Appalachian region with Leonard City. But anyway, also one more question about the Good Samaritan. How many cans or bags of food are there in, they put in one bag? Let's see. I think I saw your hand first out of the corner of my eye. 20 different bags. So if we've got 20 items that go in every bag, here's the math question. We're a full-service church. We're trying to teach them everything. So we're trying to teach them math. If we brought in 2,600 cans in all, how many bags is that? Let's see. Do you think you got this? How many?
25.
How many? 135. You're just making up numbers, whatever your mom is whispering to you. 2,600, and when it takes 20 for one bag, So, is that Lily there? Lily Bell? 130, not 103. Okay, good job, both of you guys. That's how many families you fed this week. That is awesome, and we thank you so much for it. Then we talked about a mission project that we have, an international mission project. Talked about a different country. Two of our young people from our church are there today. They're down there right now. So, Parker, I saw your hand go up. Do you know what the name of the country is? You remember? You just raised your hand because you could. You've already answered one, you smarty pants. Somebody who hadn't answered one yet. Come on, what country was their first country? Yes, sir. You got nothing. Yes. Honduras, that's right, the country of Honduras. Two of our students are there right now. Mallory and Cody are down there serving this week with our mission partners. You remember the couple that owned that ministry, husband and wife? Yes, ma'am. Brad and Christy Linderman. Anybody remember the name of the ministry? You're just up in it. Yes. Oh, man, when I finally call on you again, you forgot it. Somebody else, this ministry in Honduras. Yes, ma'am, on the end. No, not Tahachi. That'll be an answer in a minute. Keep that name. The name of the ministry, yes. Hope Through Him, that's right. Man, you all did this every night. Now your parents are here and you panicked. Come on, stay with me. Okay, so, and by the way, we have a prayer request from that ministry today. I had a request from Mallory. She said that there was a baby that was born premature, and I don't remember exactly how premature. Where's Miss Kim? Are you here? Kim Van Valkenburg. Okay, let me find the message. This is a very important prayer request. We not only support those ministries by going and helping, but we also pray for them. So Miss Kim said, here's a prayer request from Mallory. As they did house visits yesterday, they met a mom with a premature baby that was 13 days old. They were already at home, and the baby isn't doing well. The Lindermans go back to that area all the time. But there's a brand new baby, only 13 days old, and the baby was born premature. So I don't know the name of the baby. We don't know anything about it. But sometimes when we're praying, we get prayer requests like that. Just kind of a little bit of it. So what I want to do right now is to pray for that family and that baby. They don't have good hospitals like we do. They don't have children's hospital and neonatal units and all that. And imagine being down there in a third world kind of setting and having this baby that should still be in a neonatal unit, and she's already at home and not doing well. So I'm going to ask one of our missionaries, Mr. Phil Holmes. Phil is the director of missions for Loudoun County, and he's been on the mission field before, served, lived there with his family, and I know how critical those kind of prayer requests are. Phil, would you pray for that baby and that family right now? Amen. Thank you, Phil. And remember to pray for that work in Honduras. And God knows the baby and everything about it, all right? So then the next night we talked about two national mission partners. One of those is out west. Anybody remember the one that's out west? What state it's in? Yes, ma'am. Yes. New Mexico, that's right. And it's among an indigenous people group, Native Americans. Anybody know what the group is, those Native Americans? Bruin? The Navajo, that's right. And we work at a couple of different churches, but one of them in particular, the name of the church, anybody remember? Somebody already called that name out a minute ago. Yes, ma'am, back there in the back. Yes, you're right there. You're looking, yes. Tehachi, it's the Tehachi Baptist Church in New Mexico on the Navajo Reservation. And one of the pastor that we work with, anybody remember the pastor's name? Let's see, there's some thinking going on. You got this one? Oh, yes, ma'am. Pastor Aaron, that's right. And he is really a great guy. We really love him. We go out there and do some work. Anybody remember the kinds of things we help them with? Yes. With food? Yep, we sent buckets of blessings to them during the time of the pandemic. What else do we do? Yes, ma'am. Say it loud. Say it loud. Construction, that's right. Somebody, one more. What's one more project we do? We help them with. Yes. VBS, that's right. We help them with VBS. Then we have a mission partnership in another state that borders on Tennessee. Anybody remember that one? The two same girls keep raising their hand every time. Yes, sir. Kentucky, that's right. Yo, Kentucky. If anybody needs missionary help, it's Kentucky. Well, and Alabama. But we need to go up there and help those folks in Kentucky. And it's up in the northern part near two of our favorite locations to take a field trip or a vacation. Anybody remember either one of those two? Yes. The Ark exhibit, yes, the Ark Encounter. It's up there in our association. The other one is... Let's see. I'll let you name both of them. The Creation Museum. That's right. Both of those are right there in that region that we work. How many churches are in that association? Yeah, I saw you, Lily. 12 churches. That's right. It's called, what's the name of the association? Anybody remember? Yes, ma'am. The Union Association of Baptists. We go up there, do the same things, construction, Bible schools, helping them in all of those things. So those were the mission partners that we shared about this week. Those are the ones who are going to get the funds from the giving for the offerings for the missions. They'll receive whatever they need, whatever project they have going on. We don't limit it in any way. We give every penny of that to the mission project, whatever is needed to help do that ministry, okay? So that was the mission partners. Then on Thursday night, I shared the plan of salvation. I reminded everybody that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son. And whoever believed in him would not perish but have everlasting life. And that means everybody. So I would say it like this. Miss Yvette, how are you, little girl? It's good to see you tonight. I'm glad you're here. Did you know that verse can be quoted like this? For God so loved Yvette. And that's what it means. The world or the people of the world. So when you think about it that way, for God, the creator of all creation, thought about little Miss Yvette. How awesome is that? And he loved you so much that if Yvette would believe in Jesus, she would not perish but have everlasting life. That's how we began, how I began the plan of salvation, how I explained to children and adults and everyone in between, this is the love that God has for us. The problem is we've all sinned, and I ask people about sin. So let me hear again from the kids. What's a sin that a kid can commit? Lily, you really are into this one. You love sin. Say what? Okay, you don't love sin. You also don't get sarcasm yet. But go ahead, tell me a sin that not listening to your parents. Amen. Can I get an amen, Dad? Yeah, there you go. Okay, another sin. Telling a lie. Those are all sins. So even children can sin. Yes, ma'am, one more. Your sister tempting you to lie to your parents. That's your sister's sin. Let me tell you two sins, Ella. Your sister's sin for tempting you, and then your sin for giving in to it, and then your sin for tattling. So there's a whole list of them there. All right. So we need to be reminded that everybody has sinned. And I know us older guys, older men and women, we've committed sins. I sometimes call them adult sins. And you all know what I'm talking about. But sin is simply this. It's disobedience. God says, do this, and we don't do it. God says, don't do this, and we do it. That's a sin. Okay, so it needs to be understood at that simple kind of level. The problem is because of that sin, it separates us from God. We can't get to him. And the wages, what we've earned, what we deserve, what God should give us is punishment, even death. But God doesn't want to give us that. He wants to give us a gift. For the reason is because He loves you, not because you're good, because there's none of us that are good. He wants to give you this gift of eternal life because He loves you. What a great God we serve. And He'll give you that gift. Every one of you. Parents, you may be here today and you're not yet a Christian. I'm going to tell you, God will save you tonight. He will rescue you forever. You must acknowledge your sin, recognize it, and then repent of it. It says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. So God proved His love to us while we were still sinners. Christ died on the cross to pay for the price for our sin. He took on Himself. And I used an illustration this week about a child maybe breaking a window, and when they broke the window, their parent paid for it. Their parent. Well, God, their Heavenly Father, He paid for our sin by sending Jesus to earth so that if anyone would believe, they could be born again. And all we need to do is confess our sins. Tell Him, God, I'm sorry. It is my sin. I own it. I can't blame my sister because she tempted me. I have to admit that I still fell into that sin. All of us must do that. I've been tempted by other people. And again, my sin wasn't that they tempted me. My sin was that I gave into it, that I did what I shouldn't do. So that was my sin, and I had to accept that and then call on God and tell Him, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Come in my heart. Wash me. Save me. Lord, please deliver me from this. I believe that You're the Son of God. I believe You love me, and I give You my life right now. And the Bible says, whoever, anywhere, any country, in Honduras, in Kentucky, in New Mexico, in Loudoun County, in some other country, anywhere, anytime in the history of the world, if we will repent, God will save us. That's the best news ever. It's good news. Do you believe that Jesus loves you? Do you believe that Jesus paid the price for your sin? Do you believe that God gave His Son just for you? If you do, you can be saved today. Even here in this room tonight, you can trust Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And I would invite you to do that. I'd encourage you to do that. When we would do that, when I did that on Thursday night, I told the kids, now if you feel like God is speaking to you, you may feel something inside. There may be some anxiousness about you. Whatever it might be, when you go to your class, we would dismiss them. When you go to your class, go tell your teacher, I think I need to talk to the preacher, or I think I need to be saved. I think I need to become a Christian. Whatever words you need to do, but you do that. And we do it on purpose, and some of you may not appreciate that style, but I intentionally put some roadblocks in because I've seen it done before. I've seen people say, everybody that wants to be saved, raise your hand, and everybody in the building wants to be saved. All the kids want to be saved. Everybody that wants to be saved, if you get saved, come on down. We'll pray with you, and then we'll give you a sucker when you leave. Everybody comes. But the problem is, I believe I have to deal with that later as a pastor. When that kid is 15 or 25 or 35, they say, I came forward, but I'm not sure that was real. Sometimes that herd mentality coming in, we just have to be careful. So we won't do that. Instead, we say, if you really feel this calling from God, if you really feel this, then you're going to have to go talk to your teacher or talk to the preacher or somebody around that. Now, we know the bottom line. One of the kids, as they went home the other night, on Friday night, I believe, they went home and said to their mom, as they were having prayer together, I need to be saved. They didn't come to the preacher. They didn't do any of that stuff. They just knew they needed to be saved. So you can be saved anywhere, anytime. But as a church, we refuse to do anything that might confuse the kids later on. So that's why we do it that way, just for your information, okay? And I told you I'd just be about 20 minutes. I've gone long because I'm seeing the rain. It is pouring out there. So going to be just a little bit longer. Hopefully let it blow over. Come on, blow over. There's some serious rain out there. So then after we do that, every night they go to classes, go to recreation, go to crafts, go to music. And then their classes, they go to supper time, have a meal prepared for them every night. All of that and rotating around through the system. Come back at 8:45, come into the sanctuary, and we do our closing assembly when we would give the reports about who won, the boys or the girls, and then we'd sing some songs together, okay? So we're going to do that tonight. We're going to sing a couple of songs with you. Now, we have some things that every Bible school, Concrete and Cranes, was the theme. We did, and I don't think we did the theme verse either, by the way. You got that verse up there? Kids, let's read the verse to your parents. This verse, everybody read it out loud real good and clear, okay? Here we go. Being confident of this very thing, that He who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Philippians 1:6. And then there's a motto for the week, a theme for the whole week, and it is Jesus, our strong foundation. That didn't sound like enough for this group. We were a little more rowdy, so we did it differently. Let's show them how we did it. Are you ready? Kids, Jesus, our strong foundation. So if you got any of that at home when they got there, it's our fault, and I don't apologize a bit. I'm glad that they remembered it. So Jesus is our strong foundation. Then we come back and do some songs. I think we're going to do two songs that were part of the Bible school curriculum. And then we have two songs that are kind of New Providence standards. We've been doing this for years and years and years. So we're going to do all four of those. And then the baptism and hope to the goodness of the Lord that the rain has ceased by that time. Man, it's pouring out there. So anyway, any of the kids that are willing to come and help sing and show your parents the motions and all that, come on down. Get up here on the stage. Let's do this. Miss Claire, are you ready? Yeah. Keep coming, guys. Keep coming. Got any more out there? Come on down if you want to do it. You want to do it? I think everybody needs to stand up for this. Y'all need to stand up even if you don't know the song. Come on. Every night we would choose a different group or two to come down and do this. So tonight's just kind of a cross-section of all of them. Y'all did well. But we did two other songs, right? So we're going to do those next. And I'm going to make an announcement. If you are here right now and able to help the guys, they're going to go and move the refreshments and all that from the tent to the youth house. So if a couple of you men could help do that, I would invite you to miss the My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. I know some of you aren't thrilled with that anyway. So you guys could go do that. So we will just move our fellowship from the tent down to the youth house. Unfortunately, that will not allow us to use the bounce houses tonight. It's still pouring. Looks like the weather is right on top of us and not going to move out. So there you go. But the parents want you guys to stay in here for this next song because this is going to wear you out. Okay? Yes. No way, Jose. So we're going to do that. And then I just got another text message from Mallory, and the baby's name is Jeremy. And Jeremy is at home. She sent me a picture of him. We'll post that for you later. I want you to continue praying for that family in Honduras, okay? So there's lots of stuff going on. It's always like that around here, by the way. Life just keeps going on. Let's sing the two last songs that we sing every year. One of them is called My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. Everybody needs to stand up for this one. Okay, come. Hey, Jenkins girls, y'all need to stand up. Here we go, tear. Did you have a knee replacement or something a while back? Okay, so you're good then. You have no excuses. I was trying to let you out of it. When you hear the sound, what's the sound? Buh, 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 buh. Everybody say it. Buh, 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 buh. If you hear the sound buh, like in Bonnie, if you're standing, you'll sit. If you're sitting, you will stand. Pretty simple, right? Just follow along. It's that simple. Here we go, guys. Show them how to do it. My Bonnie lies. Okay, got it. Sit down and bend down. Jason, a little more. Come on, old man. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. My Bonnie lies over the sea. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Bring back. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Bring back. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. That's pretty good, but we got to speed it up a little bit and show them really how to do it. Are you ready? Here we go. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. My Bonnie lies over the sea. My Bonnie lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Bring back. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Bring back. Oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Pretty good. You think they did good? You think they can handle my rock? You think they can do it? We got to show them. Anybody got a rock? This is a motion song. You got to do this with us. It goes like this. Jesus is my rock, okay? He's my rock. Do this. He's my sword, and he's my shield. Shield. Pop that shield up. He's my rock, my sword, my shield. Pop it. Come on. He's my rock, my sword, my shield. Now listen to this carefully. He's duh. He's duh hub in duh middle of the wheel. All right? He's my rock, my sword, my shield. He's the hub in the middle of the wheel. There you go. Then he's the lily of the valley. Now, that sounds a little too much for some of you old people, but lily of the valley, we all get that. So just bend down and pick a lily. He's the lily of the valley. Pick it up and just smell it real good. A bright and shining star. Hold a star. Point toward the star. Then I don't care what the people say. I'm getting down on my knees to pray. And I'm going to wait right here till Jesus comes. 2, 3. I'm going to wait right here till Jesus comes. 2, 3. I know. Are you ready? Here we go. Anybody got a rock? Okay, even you old people can do this, Wes. Come on, just show me a rock right here. You can do it. Willie Morris, show me your rock. Come on, Willie. So there you go. All right. He's my rock, my sword, my shield. He's the hope in the middle of the wheel. He's a lily of the valley. A bride. If you've joined us online, you're welcome to this extended version, by the way. All right. Last thing we need to do, the guys are coming back in. I think that means they've got everything taken to the youth house. Last thing we need to do is our baptism service. So I know that we have at least one. I don't know who else might be planning on being baptized. But if you're here and you want to be baptized tonight because you were saved at Bible school, I invite you right now to come right here and let me introduce you. So come on down here. Ella, where art thou? There she is. Come on, girl. Anybody else wanting to be baptized tonight? Come right here, right here. You're so awesome. Yay, Ella. She prayed and invited Jesus into her heart. Best testimony ever. She said, as soon as you started talking, I felt something in my belly just doing this. What a sweet testimony. Throat was dry. She was nervous. And we did that as I described it. I go to my office in the other building. She's already in my office before I get down there. She wanted to do business with Jesus. So we're so proud of you. And she's come tonight to be baptized. Let the world know this. And that's what baptism is. It's a testimony. It doesn't get you to heaven. You go to heaven because you're born again. You get to testify and identify with other believers. So I told her that means that she is now my little sister. And finally, there's a handsome man in your life, because I know those other guys. Yeah, so this one is, amen, that's my little sweetheart. And I'm going to ask her dad. We always do this. We say we need to receive her as a member being baptized. And so will somebody make a motion to baptize her? I thought you might do that, brother. And all in favor of that, say, dunker, preacher. All opposed to that, I'll be at the ice cream fellowship. We can talk about it there, all right? So are you all happy about that and celebrating with Ella? How about giving her a round of applause? All right. So we're going to go, and Miss Deb is going to help you get ready. If your mom wants to go to take pictures or something, just go this direction. Go on, young lady. We'll meet you back there in just a moment. So we're going to have just a couple of moments here of pause. And I would just love again to thank our leaders. And I'm going to ask, is Jennifer still here? Did she slip out? There she is. Miss Jennifer, I want you to come down here. Come on. I know I didn't warn you about this. And Carol to come down here. These ladies lead our Bible school and our children's ministry all the time. So I would just love for you guys to share about the Bible project we've got going on, about some of the things we're doing and other activities for children's ministry. You need to grab a mic up there so they can hear you. So but we need to know about the children's activities coming up, and school is coming up. By the way, you know school is just in about 3 weeks? Yay, all you parents say hallelujah right there, getting them back to school. But this is Jennifer Pinkston and Carol Pickle, and they lead our children's ministry. Pastor Gary is the coordinator that oversees it, but they do the day-to-day stuff and just do all the ministry. Tell them about Wednesday night, Sunday school, all that, because I need a couple minutes to get ready. There you go. Thank you.
Okay, good evening. We're so glad that you all are here with us tonight. And as Preacher Mark has already said, it has been a wonderful, wonderful week of VBS, and just so good to be back and able to do things together as a church family. And we have lots of things going on now that we're able to be back in buildings together and doing things again. We do have a lot of things going on with the kids. The first thing that we have that we started back several months ago, we have a Wednesday night kids club, and that is for preschool ages 3 through 6th grade on Wednesday night. And then we also have our youth program for the high school kids, or for 7th through 12th, going on at the same time, and prayer meetings, so on Wednesdays, and choir practice. So we literally have something going on here for everybody in the family on Wednesday. And Kids Club, right now we're doing a program called Team Kid, and we have a Bible story, we have a game time, and we have a missions time. And so we rotate through those and have a lot of fun on Wednesday nights with the kids. And we also have on Sunday mornings, we have Sunday school classes for everybody in the family. Everything's back up and going, and all the classes are back in our original rooms. And it's just a wonderful time together as well. So if you don't have a church home on Sunday or Wednesday, I would invite you to come and be with us. And we're really, really excited about what's going on, and trying to encourage, as you may have seen, some of the Bibles in the back, and the kids maybe have brought some Bibles home this week. We're trying to help get Bibles into the hands of kids that maybe don't have one, and that's something that we're going to continue on as the new school year starts. There's a Bring Your Bible to School Day in October that we're really excited about, and we will be doing some things working up toward that. So that's coming up. And we do have some Bibles at the cross that we place out there just for people that stop by, driving on the interstate, see the cross and come by. Our people in the community can come, and when they see the cross, they come up here for different reasons, but when they get to the cross, the plan of salvation is around it, and there's a box of Bibles right there that says "Find Hope Here," and we truly believe that that is the only hope that we have, is in the Lord and His salvation, and they can find that at the cross, and hopefully take a Bible with them. Carol?
I have nothing else to add. I'm just here for moral support. But I do appreciate everybody that came out to Bible school this year. I wasn't able to do it for the first time in years. I was here Monday and Tuesday, but then that's when my mom started getting bad. And I do appreciate all the help. I think we had probably more volunteers this year than we have. I mean, we were overflowing with volunteers, and that is awesome, because that's one thing I start praying for at the first of the year is volunteers. I've been director for years and years, and thankful that Jennifer stepped in this year, because it has been just a crazy summer at our house. But I start praying in the first of the year for volunteers, and this year, I mean, the Lord just beyond blessed us. I mean, we had not only a lot of kids show up, but we had volunteers, you know, 4 to 6 in each classroom, and the youth really showed up this year. We had a lot of youth volunteers, and that was awesome. And security, I don't know any time that we had that many people volunteer to be security, and that just them walking around the campus just to make sure that nobody was here that shouldn't be here, and just watching out for us was awesome. So I do thank everybody for bringing your kids out, and for everybody that volunteered. It's been a great VBS this year.
Amen. Thank you, ladies. I appreciate you giving me just a moment to get up here. Ella, come on down, young lady. You've been in colder water? Well, good girl. Can I tell you a secret? About 2 weeks ago, this pool, we put water in it every time we baptize. And see that hole there and that hole there? One, the water comes out. The other, it kind of circulates and goes through a water heater underneath here. Well, the water heater went out, and I didn't tell you.
Yep,
2 weeks. Yeah. So it's a little cool, and I'm standing here talking because I'm wearing waders, and I can't feel it. So you want to just hang out a while? And no, we better not do that. I love you. How about we turn around, because your mom is up here, and I'm going to baptize you in this direction, and I'm going to baptize. I'll hold this up and squeeze your nose in just a moment, and I'll lay you down and pick you back up. And what that symbolizes is that you are laying down into what we call a liquid grave. Like Jesus was buried in a grave on the third day. Remember what he did? What happened? He was resurrected. He rose from the dead. So you're going to be raised up. This is a symbol. And you're going to be raised up in resurrection power like Jesus. And you're going to be a Christian, a follower of Jesus, who's now given your very first testimony what Jesus did in your heart. All right? I'm so proud of you. Ella, my little sister, upon your profession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I baptize you, my sister, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good job, Lord. Amen. Amen. Now our job begins as a church family, our job to equip her and train her and develop her, support her family, help them all to know how to walk with Christ every day. The Bible says, train up a child in the way that he or she should go, and when they're old, they will not depart from it. But training the child doesn't mean we just baptize them. It means we baptize, we get them in discipleship classes and Sunday, all of those things. And as we do, we can see some of the finest Christian men and women in the history of the world because you were faithful to your part of this covenant she just presented and the testimony she just showed the world. Thank you for doing that. I love you. Let me pray with you. Father, we praise the name of Jesus. You are good and great, and you are surely worthy to be praised. Thank you for Ella and her testimony. Thank you for saving her forever and ever, bringing her into the family of God. I pray, Lord, that you will help us as her church family, her brothers and sisters in Christ, her biological family, but all of us to support her and them, the family, to show them love and encouragement and to walk with them through every situation, every circumstance of life. May we be part of the family of God and honor you. I love you, and I thank you so much for this day. Now, Lord, go with us. Give us a good rest of the evening. We're going to give you great praise for all you do. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We really need you to come down to the youth house now. Now, I think it's still raining, and it is a gully washer. Somebody said we'd already had like 2 inches of rain in this time. So we need you to come and join us down there because we got about 20 gallons of ice cream, and I can only eat so much. So please come down, enjoy some ice cream and cookies and watermelon and fellowship, and be sure and find Ella and congratulate her for this night. All right? We love you. Thank you so much for being here. That concludes Vacation Bible School 2021. If you had a great time in Bible school, amen. God bless you. I have a hand raised back there. Okay, if you want to ride in the van down there to the youth house, you can do that. We'll provide transportation to and from, all right? So do that and join us. If you're online, thank you. God bless you. And our regular schedule is back beginning tomorrow, so all of the activities are going on. School's coming. Keep praying. We love you. You're dismissed. Have a great day.